Hi everyone. Is it possible to overcome habits such as smoking, alcohol, and various drugs? Yes, of course. So the drugs which will be useful for that is called as de-addictive drugs. So normally the individuals are going to be addicted towards the opium category of the drugs, and moreover smoking, alcohol, etc. Okay, so before going to this, first we'll see like what are the different drugs available which will cause habit forming. So what actually you mean by habit forming, what is the difference between the abuse and tolerance? Okay, so abuse, so normally we'll use these drugs for the therapeutical activity. Say for example morphine or opium analgesics are useful when there is a severe pain. But without pain, if they are misusing these drugs, that is called as abuse. Okay, so the most of the narcotic drugs are going to be abused. Tolerance, so normally when we ingest this particular medication, so there will be various metabolic enzymes are there that is going to be over expressed, so resulting of that the metabolism of these drugs are going to be enhanced. Otherwise the receptors which are involved are going to be down regulated. Because of that the effect is not going to be seen as previously. So normally what we do is we'll increase the dose of the drug. So say for example in case of the smoking, first you will take one cigarette, then to have the same pleasure you will be taking second cigarette, okay, two cigarettes per day. So likewise you will be increasing the dose to have the same kind of pleasure. Okay, so normally these drugs are said to be the street drugs. Okay, normal cocaine, alcohol, morphine, all these are called as street drugs. Hard drugs, so hard drugs are the drugs which will physically we are completely depend on these specific drugs. Okay, without these drugs there will be physical imbalance and the one is not able to tolerate. Okay, so those drugs are said to be the hard drugs. Okay, so soft drugs, normally the individuals are going to be psychologically depend on these drugs. Okay, example tea, coffee, okay, so LSD, etc. Recreational drug, party drugs, club drugs are the derivatives of morphine which have various degree of effects. So what basically these morphine drugs will do, let's see. So here morphine drugs are the codeine or inhibit the reuptake of the dopamine in the presynaptic nerve. So resulting of that the dopamine concentration in the synaptics is going to be enhanced, so that give the extra pleasure. Okay, moreover the drugs are going to be inhibit this GABA receptor, so thereby the GABA receptor normally involved in the influx of the chlorine. Okay, that causes hyperpolarization, leads to the decreased nerve transmission. Okay, so normally these drugs are going to be work, so that is the reason why we'll feel sedation or we'll feel euphoric activity. Okay, so to treat this kind of medication, so normal psychological support should be there. Along with this, various pharmacological agents are used. First we will see like the agents which will be useful to treat the opium dependent addiction. Okay, so here normally we will take the methadone and buprenorphine. Okay, these drugs are the analogs of the opioid, and is substituted agonist, so is going to be replace the receptor, whereas codeine and other active substances cannot occupy this. So it is a long acting agonist. Apart from that, we'll use this antagonist which will block this opium receptors. Example naltrexone, normally we'll ingest 50 milligrams OD. Okay, so normally opium addiction can be treated by using these specific drugs. If you block this particular receptor, so here actual drug, maybe morphine, codeine, doesn't have any space to occupy these receptors. Thereby, the therapeutical activity is not going to be there. So, the individual is not going to feel euphoria. So, that is the basic logic of doing this. Next, nicotine. Nicotine, normally tobacco, okay, cigarettes, bidis, all this consisting of this nicotine. Nicotinic receptors are going to be present in the brain, and that will allow the secretion of the dopamine. So, that is the reason why the individual who smoke feel bit relaxed. Okay, so here again the dependency of the drug cigarettes are going to be enhanced day by day. Okay, so we can use we can de-addict by using vernicline. Vernicline is the drug which blocks this nicotinic receptors. So resulting of that, the nicotine cannot occupy this receptors. So resulting, there don't be any secretion of the dopamine. So the individual will not feel relaxation. Okay. So apart from this, bupropion. Okay, this is the drug that is also inhibit partially the nicotinic receptors. So normally dose is 150 to 300 milligrams BD. Next, alcohol. Alcohol one is the commonest abusing drug. Okay, so it will be in various forms. So like beer, whiskey, rum, all this. Here in every alcohol beverage, the ethanol is the only active ingredient in different concentration. In case of beer, it is around 6 to 12%. In case of whiskey, it may be up to 35%. So only the quantity of the alcohol is varies. Okay, so here first we will see like normally how the alcohol is going to be get metabolized. Okay, so normally ethanol in the presence of alcohol dehydrogenase enzyme. So here this ethanol is going to convert into the acetaldehyde. So this acetaldehyde is a aldehyde group. So this acetaldehyde is going to be converted into the into acetate in the presence of acetaldehyde dehydrogenase. So this specific enzyme is responsible to decrease the toxicity of the acetaldehyde by converting to acetic acid. Okay, so but the drugs, for example disulfiram, so these drugs are going to be inhibit the acetaldehyde dehydrogenase enzyme. This enzyme is going to be blocked. So resulting of that, the systemic concentration of acetaldehyde is going to be enhanced. So when this acetaldehyde is enhanced, it triggers the CPZ, causes the severe vomiting, so blurred vision, palpitation, all these symptoms are going to be seen. So whenever the individual take this alcohol, the same thing is going to be repeated. So resulting of this unpleasant activities, the individual will not interested to take the alcohol anymore. So this is how we can treat the addiction of alcohol. So apart from that, we have naltrexone, ondansetron, fluoxetine and topiramate. All these drugs will work either serotonin or 5-HT3 receptor, and it's going to be blocked at a specific sites and causes this de-addiction of this alcohol. Okay, so the de-addiction is very very important for the healthy society. Okay, so that is the reason there should be a close psychological monitor as well as the physical monitor of those individuals who are addicted. Okay, because addicted one can go for any extent for money and whatever, so which make cause the society in a danger. Okay, so I hope this video is useful. Thank you.